Ayun, I would like to greet everyone. A happy Sabbath. Happy Sabbath po.
Happy Sabbath. Ayun,
so let happy us praise Sabbath. God. Ayun. Let us praise God for this wonderful opportunity that given to us. Actually, nag-start lang po kami mga 34th batch missionary to have this gathering together with the missionaries. And I'm glad to know na, kumbaga, this time is not, hindi lamang po ang mga 34th batch missionary ang amin po, atin po makakasama, but together with other senior missionaries. So let us praise God for this wonderful opportunity na ipinagkaloob sa atin. At least, despite we are restrained to have a physical gathering, by God's grace is through this medium, we can be able to have this fellowship ano, together with our fellow seniors, senior missionaries. Kanina po, bago po nag-start, I try to scan my Zoom. I'm trying to see if there are foreigner in our midst, because if ever na merong foreigner sa ating kalagitnaan, I will be forced to speak in English. But I'm glad to know na lahat po tayo dito Filipino. But I will try to present this message sa paraan na masigit nating maunawaan. And I'm praying for the presence of the Holy Spirit to be in our midst, not just to me as God's mouthpiece to share His message, but also to the rest of us so that we can be able to have enlightenment from the Holy Spirit so that we can be able to understand God's message. So before we start, let us bow again our heads for a word of prayer. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we praise your name. We would like, O Lord, to thank you for this wonderful privilege, O God, that you have given to us. Lord, indeed, it is only by your grace that we have this privilege of Father God to worship you in spirit and in truth. Thank you for gathering us here through this virtual fellowship. And as we gather, O God, to study your word, we would like to ask for your presence in our midst, O Holy Spirit, to guide us and to enlighten our minds so that we can be able to comprehend the things that we are going to study. And the things that we are going to study, Lord, will be our guiding principles as we live in this world, waiting for that glorious event and no other than the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for your grace and thank you for the forgiveness of our sins. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Ayun, so thank you, Brother Jeffon, for that very short introduction. Actually, prior to this meeting, Brother Ronnie Istanke is humingi po siya sa akin ng information about sa akin pong sarili. And sabi niya, paano ba kita ipapakilala? Kasi ang tawagan namin, siyempre sa Bisaya ay bay, yung magkakaibigan. Paano ba kita ipakilala, bay? So, as simply as possible. Na alam mo, hindi ko naman siguro kailangan isa-isahin pa, no? Kasi kumbaga, I would like to focus on the message as well as to lift up Jesus Christ. So ang origin ko po, mga kapatid, although we are now in Antipolo Rizal, but my origin is from Mindanao sa Pitogo, Sambuanga del Sur, isa po sa mga town sa Pagadian City. Ayun. So I think 2008, if I'm not mistaken, we migrate from Mindanao papunta dito po sa Antipolo. So ang address ko na po talaga is Antipolo Rizal dito po sa Luzon. So kung dati po ay sabi nga nila Bisdak daw, Bisayang dako, but now is Bisalog na, Bisayang Tagalog. Ayun. So thank you for this wonderful time and opportunity. And let us praise God. And I would like to share a screen. Wait lang po tayo sandali. Share ko lang po yung akin pong PowerPoint natin pong pag-aaralan this morning. Ayun, so nakikita na po ba mga kapatid?
Yes.
Nakikita na po ba? Okay. So, as far as we know, alam po natin mga kapatid ano, na sa nakalipas na mga buwan from January until now, sunod-sunod po yung mga pangyayari na hindi po natin inaasahan. Ayun. So, nandyan po yung pagsabog ng Bulkang Taal. At yan po ay halos kasabayan po noong nagkaroon po ng bushfire sa Australia. And then yun pong muntikan ng magkaroon ng gera between US and it's Pakistan. I'm not really sure. And then sinundan po ito mga kapatid ng pagkakaroon ng pandemic outbreak ng coronavirus. So as a Seventh-day Adventist mga kapatid, hindi po natin ito ikinagugulat. So these events that happens all throughout this past few months in this year 2020 ay tinitingnan natin ito mga kapatid as a fulfillment of what we call the last day events, which is predicted already sa Bible po mga kapatid. So every time na meron pong mga events o catastrophic events, calamities, pandemic like this, is we look at it as what? As a fulfillment of God's promise that He will come. As a fulfillment of the signs of the times, bilang katunayan na ang ating Panginoon ay malapit ng pumarito. So we are blessed that we have this kind of prophetic insight based from the Bible, because we look at it not as a yung kawalang pag-asa, but rather we look at it as fulfillment of God's promise of His soon return, particularly Jesus Christ. Ayun, this today's sermon mga kapatid, I entitled it When God Roars, Getting Ready for the Coming Judgment. Actually, it's a exposition of the book of Amos. And the book of Amos, mga kapatid, is one of the books of the minor prophet in the Old Testament. And this sermon is an exposition kung ano po yung mensahe ng ating Panginoon dito po sa aklat po ng Amos. Ayun. So when we're going to talk about judgment, usually ang connotation ng karamihan when we are talking about judgment, para po sa karamihan, it connotes a something negative. We understand it karamihan sa atin as what? As a we understand it as something like yung execution. Yun po yung pumapasok sa ating mga kaisipan po mga kapatid when we are talking about judgment. But judgment itself mga kapatid ay it doesn't mean always as negative, but rather judgment means a verdict or a decision as a consequence, yung decision ng ating Panginoon as a consequence doon sa mga choices na atin pong ginawa. So let us look on the judgment po mga kapatid, not just as God who will execute those who are sinners with His wrath and anger, but rather let us look to this judgment as what? As God's warning of mercy for us not to be part of the final judgment. But judgment itself, it means a verdict or a decision. Okay, so when we're going to study the book of Amos, the most common and the most quoted na verse po sa aklat po ng Amos found in chapter 4, verse 12. Kung atin pong mapapansin, it is the most quoted na verse sa book po ng Amos. Ang sabi po dyan, sa salin po ng New King James Version, ang sabi dyan, "Therefore, thus will I do to you, O Israel, because I will do this to you, prepare to meet your God, O Israel." So usually, marami po tayong mga sermons na narinig, pertaining to this, and mostly they entitled it as prepare to meet thy God. So bakit po kaya sinasabi po dito mga minamahal na mga kapatid na tayo po ay maghanda in order for us to meet our God. Ayon. So before we dig in, let us consider first the background of this book, the writer and his background. Ayon. So si Amos po ay hindi po siya kagaya ng ibang prophet like si Prophet Jeremiah or other prophet that they have a meron po silang talagang background as a prophet. Pero ito pong si Amos po mga kapatid, he is wala po siyang family na pinanggalingan na directly naglilingkod sa Diyos like prophet or priest, but Amos is a shepherd. Siya po ay tagapag-alaga ng tupa. And not only that, Amos is a farmer who is tending pig trees po mga kapatid. And originally, he is not from the land of Israel, which is the northern kingdom, northern part of the kingdom, but rather, he is from the land of Judah. Because during that time, na-divide na po yung kingdom of Israel. Hindi po kagaya sa panahon po ni, sa time po ni Saul, sa time ni David at ni Solomon, ang Israel po as United Kingdom po sila during that time. But during this time of during the ministry of Prophet Amos po mga kapatid, the kingdom of Israel was already divided. So it's a result of the wrong decision of the son of Solomon, namely Rehoboam. So yun pong 10 tribes ay nasa ilalim po ng rule ni Jeroboam. And then yun pong southern kingdom, which is the kingdom of Judah, is ruled by King Rehoboam, the son of Solomon. At yun pong northern kingdom, it's composed of 10 tribes of Israel. Samantala, yun pong southern kingdom, which is the kingdom of Judah, is composed of 2 tribes, primarily the kingdom, the people of Judah and part of Benjamin, and I think it's other part of Joseph. Okay, let us continue. So ito po yung mga list ng kings ng Judah, ng Southern Kingdom, at the same time ng Israel, ng Northern Kingdom, na ang capital ay Samaria. So si Amos po ay nag-start ng kanyang ministry during the time of Hosea, na 7th king ng Southern Kingdom, while sa panahon po ng sa Northern Kingdom naman is si Jeroboam II. Si Jeroboam II po mga kapatid, if we're going to start from the last, is the 5th kingdom before Israel was taken captive by the Assyrian by the Assyrian. Ayun. So yun pong statement or expression that the Lord roars like a lion, yan po ay makikita po natin mga kapatid sa chapter 1 verse 2 ng aklat po ng Amos. So ang sabi po diyan, the Lord roars from Zion and utters his voice from Jerusalem, the pastures of shepherds mourn and the top of Carmel with hers. And sa verse 8 po mga kapatid sa chapter 3, ganito po ang sabi, a lion has roared, who will not fear? The Lord God has spoken, who can but prophesy? So, ano po bang ibig sabihin mga kapatid? This expression, the Lord roars like a lion. So, pag-aaralan po natin yan mamaya. Sa salin po ng NKJV, natin pong binasa, kanina, because God will... darating po yung time na ang Panginoon is pictured as the roaring lion. Kaya po ang sabi po ni Prophet Amos sa Israel is prepare to meet thy God. So meron pong tatlong question na ito po yung maging, dito po iikot yung atin pong study sa book po ng Amos po mga minamahal na mga kapatid. First is, what does the expression when God roars means? Ano po ba ang ibig sabihin kapag kasi nasabi ng Biblia na ang Diyos ay umuungal na kagaya ng leon? So pangalawa, why does God called His people to prepare? Ano po ba ang bagay o mga bagay na darating, bakit sa kailangan mag-prepare? And lastly, how are we going to prepare? Ayun. So according to study mo, mga kapatid, alam po natin that the Bible has full of symbol and figurative expressions po. Particularly if we are studying poetic book in the Bible or prophetic. Poetic or prophetic book in the Bible, yan po ay marami po silang mga images, marami mga symbols, at marami po, mga kapatid, na mga figurative expression na yan po ay merong ibig sabihin. So according to study, the expression the Lord roars means that is equal to what? To judgment. So yun po ang ibig sabihin po, mga minamahal, mga kapatid. That's an expression that shows that a time will come, God will pronounce and God will execute His judgment. So, alam po natin in the Bible, or throughout the Bible po, mga kapatid, Jesus Christ ay inahalin tulad sa primarily yung lamb. And pangalawa, yung lion. Ito pong mga images na ito ay kapwa po ito ginamit ng ating ng Biblia to show the character of the two yung characteristic of Jesus Christ. Primarily, He is pictured as lamb because He is our Savior. He took our sins and He died on our behalf. He is a perfect sacrifice na mag-aalis ng atin pong mga kasalanan. And in the book of Revelation, even sa Old Testament, God is already pictured as the lion. This is another characteristic of God, particularly Jesus Christ, that He is called as the Lion of Judah, meaning He is our conquering King that will conquer the nation and will trample down our enemies. So that's the two characteristic of Jesus Christ. Una, ipinapakita na siya yung ating Savior. Pangalawa, ipinapakita na He is our conquering King. Mula noong siya ipinako sa krus hanggang sa panahon ngayon na siya ay namamagitan sa heavenly places, He is our perfect sacrifice as well as He is our mediator. But time will come that Jesus Christ will come as a King who will judge the nation. So, ipinapakita dito, mga minamahal, mga kapatid, that God is not just a God of mercy and God is not just a God of love. He is also a God of justice. At yan po ay pinapakita sa kanya pong karakter o sa image na ginamit bilang lion. So yung immediate context po nito, mga kapatid, when we're going to study the book of Amos, is actually it's about the judgment of the northern kingdom, which is no other than Samaria. So later we are going to identify kung bakit hinatulan ng ating Panginoon itong Northern Kingdom, particularly itong Samaria. Sa chapter 4, verse 1, ganito po ang sabi, "Hear His word, you cows of Bashan, who are on the mountain of Samaria, who oppress the poor, who crush the needy, who says to your husband, bring wine, let us drink." So in this verse po, mga kapatid, Samaria was likened to a cow. Ano po ba yung characteristic ng cow, mga kapatid? Siguro, if you have experience, if happens that you was raised in the province, ako naranasan ko personally na kumbaga nahabol ako nitong cow. Particular kapag ang itong baka ay yung lalaki o tinatawag namin na turo, tapos nakasuot ka ng pula, ay habulin ka talaga nito. So naranasan ko umakyat sa puno para hindi lang ako masungag itong kalabaw o yung cow o baka. So dito po, the Bible is using, particularly this book, is using the image of a cow to represent the northern kingdom, which is Samaria. And one of the characteristic of a cow po, mga minamahal na mga kapatid, is siya po ay nanunungag. So in the same way, ito pong kingdom of Samaria, the northern kingdom, they liken to a cow because they oppress the poor and they crush the needy. So hindi po siya naging mabuting yung ruler doon po sa kanya pong bansa na nasasakupan, but rather he oppressed the poor and he crushed the needy. So sa larger context po naman, mga kapatid, ay makikita po natin in the larger context that this judgment of God are not only limited to the northern kingdom, which is Samaria, but it is also a judgment to a neighboring countries po, mga kapatid, na nakapaligid sa bansa ng Samaria. So una po yung Syria, God pronounced them judgment because of their sins of tyranny and oppression. And also God will pronounce His judgment also, will execute His judgment to the country of Philistine because of their sins of slavery and forced migration doon po sa mga nakakonquer nila na kingdom. And also judgment against Tyre because of forced migration and desertion, and judgment of Edom because of vengeance and unforgiveness. So ito pong Edom po, mga minamahal na kapatid, is no other than a descendants of the brother of Esau, brother of Jacob, which is no other than Esau. Alam po natin na in the history na si Jacob ay meron pong kasalanan itong kay Esau. At yung mga descendants po ni Esau po, mga kapatid, which is yung mga Edomites, ay instead of forgiving their brothers other than the descendants of Israel, which is the Jews or the northern kingdom, as a descendants of God's chosen people, they cherish the behavior of unforgiveness. At nung inatake po ito, mga kapatid, itong northern kingdom ng Assyrians, hindi po sila tumulong na para iligtas yung kanila pong mga kapatid, but rather they tumulong sila sa kaaway para ilut yung mga remnant noong sa kingdom of Samaria. So they will be judged by God because of their vengeance and unforgiveness behavior. So it is also a judgment against the nation of Ammon because of violence and cruelty. And it is also a judgment against Moab because of the sins of desecration. So if we're going to see, to look at the map po, mga minamahal na mga kapatid, this nation was mentioned na they will suffer because of the judgment of God that has been pronounced them and later on God will execute, is no other than they are just a surrounding or neighboring countries in the southern kingdom and the northern kingdom. Yung Philistia, yung Edom, yung Moab ay malapit lang po yan sa kingdom of Judah, the southern kingdom. And yun pong mga nabanggit, yung Syria, yung which is the capital city is Damascus, yung Ammon, and Tyre is malapit lang din po siya sa bansa ng Northern Kingdom, yung Samaria. So meaning, these surrounding countries, they are not ignorant of God's power. Hindi sila ignorante sa kapangyarihan ng Panginoon. They are not ignorant concerning the knowledge of the true God. They are not ignorant that these people, Judah and Israel, are no other than God's chosen people. But despite of that knowledge, despite of that light that they received concerning the true God through the people, the chosen people of God, they were what? They continue to oppress their enemy, particularly God's chosen people. So, they are not, hindi po sila excuse, mga kapatid, because they have this knowledge. They knew the God of Israel because they are just a surrounding countries sa Israel at sa Judah. And this judgment also po, mga kapatid, is judgment not just to Israel himself, but rather it's also judgment concerning Judah because they are what? They despise God's law. And Israel, because of many sins, injustice, oppression to the poor, immorality, corruption, and especially idolatry na pinopromote po, particularly po mga kapatid, na mga kings ng Northern Kingdom, Jeroboam and his successor na mga sumunod sa kanya, which is King Ahab. And because of that, yung mga tao, they worship different idols and they turn their back against God. And because of that sin, God will bring them to judgment. So makikita po natin, mga kapatid, dito that God is just and God is a fair judge. Kumbaga, wala siyang kinikilingan. Hindi dahil sa we are chosen, wala po siyang favoritism na bagamat yung Israel, bagamat ang kingdom of Judah is God's, is chosen, ano po mga kapatid, hindi sila excuse sa judgment na gagawin ng Panginoon as a consequence of their choice, as a consequence of their sins. Sa salin po ng New Living Translation, ganito po ang sabi, "Therefore, I will bring upon you all the disasters I have announced. Prepare to meet your God in judgment, you people of Israel." So dito po mga kapatid, malinaw na sinasabi na kaya sinasabi ni Amos that the people of God, especially or particularly the people of Israel, the northern kingdom, to prepare to meet their God in judgment, because ay una na pong ipinahayag ng ating Panginoon ang mga disasters na darating as a consequence of their back against God. So if we're going to study the book of Amos, there are two main themes. Ito po yung pinaka-main theme po mga minamahal na mga kapatid, if we're going to study the book of Amos. First, the first theme in this book is no other than judgment. And the second main theme of this book is no other than repentance. Mga kapatid, let us try to reflect on this. When God pronounced judgment, remember this, my friend, remember this, my fellow missionaries. When God pronounced judgment, He always appeals for His people to repent. So it always goes together po mga kapatid. When God's pronounced judgment, He always appealing to His people to turn their backs against sin and to go back to God. When God pronounced judgment, He always call His people for repentance. Indeed, God is just as well as He is merciful, and He is a God of love, that He is always calling His people to repentance. Ito po yung nabanggit na po natin kanina. I have mentioned it earlier. Ito yung tinatawag na capital sins ng bansang Israel. Oppression of the poor, immorality, idolatry, and injustice. Maybe we can say, mga kapatid, we can boast and we can say in ourselves na hindi naman namin ginagawa ito, like we do not oppress the poor. But according to the commentary that I have read po mga kapatid, doing nothing good, according to Warren Wiersbe, doing nothing good is equivalent to doing evil. So let us say na wala tayong ginagawang hindi tayo nag-o-oppress ng poor. Let us say that we are not dishonest in our business. Pero ang sabi po ng commentary, doing nothing good is equivalent of doing evil. Kumusta po tayo sa atin pong mga kapatid na abot ng atin pong mga kaya, na meron tayong kakayanan upang i-lessen natin yung sufferings ng mga less fortunate, ng mga mahirap na mga tao, mga kapatid. Ano po ang atin pong ginagawa para po sa kanila? Let us remember that no, doing nothing good is equivalent of doing evil. Let us say that we do not practice idolatry, but during our time po mga kapatid, even we can boast that we are not worship graven image na hindi kagaya ng atin pong mga kaibigan na mga Katoliko, but we have many gods in our life that took our precious time na para dapat sa Panginoon. Let us reflect on this matter po, mga minamahal na mga kapatid, that because of these sins, the people of Israel has been judged by God because they neglect and they ignore repentance and the appeal of God to turn back to Him. Ayun. So another is, Amos rebukes them because of what? Because of their selfish living. They living in luxury while there are people who are less fortunate, who are suffering. They are living selfishly po mga kapatid, they care nothing doon po sa mga na-oppressed, doon po sa mga less fortunate. Amos rebukes them because of their pride, and including mga kapatid yung Sabbath breaking. Actually, this is not chapter 5, but it's chapter 8 sa book of Amos po mga kapatid. Chapter 8 verse 5. Ang sabi po dito mga kapatid, saying, "When will the new moon be passed that we may sell grain, and the Sabbath that we may trade wheat?" So alam niyo po mga kapatid, isa sa mga common problem during that time is they desecrate the Sabbath. they do their business during the Sabbath instead of focusing their mind, their being to God, who is the Lord of the Sabbath. And because of that, Amos rebukes them. Another thing, mga kapatid, ito yung tinatawag na root cause of their wickedness. Ano ba yung root cause? Ano ba yung pinakaugat o pinakapunot dulo ng kanila pong kasalanan? Una, religious formalism. How do we understand religious formalism po, mga kapatid? Pag sinabi pong religious formalism is, sa tingin mo parang sa in outside appearance, it looks like parang there's no problem. But deep inside po ay wala pong impact yung pag-worship sa ating Panginoon. Parang we worship God is because nakasanayan na natin, but it has nothing to do with our, wala siyang impact sa atin pong personal po na relasyon sa atin pong Panginoon. Parang we do it for the sake of, we traditionally practice it, pero wala pong real changes po na nangyayari po sa atin pong buhay. And that's we can consider religious formalism. And another thing is yung worship amalgamation. Pag sinabi pong worship amalgamation po, mga kapatid, is we are trying to incorporate secular practices at atin pong minimix doon sa pagsamba po natin sa ating Panginoon. Let us try to ponder upon this matter po, mga kapatid. Kung ang atin bang church, kung atin bang buhay personally is, do we amalgamate our worship? Yung baga hinahaluan natin yung ating pagsamba sa ating Panginoon. Instead of following the strictly kung ano yung sinasabi ng Bible, we try to incorporate secular practices para lang ay maging patok ang ating pagsamba sa mga worshippers po, mga kapatid. Let us always remember that the object and the focus of worship is not people, but rather it is God. And lastly, mga kapatid, is they were rebuked because one of the root cause of their sin is no other than they hate rebukes. Hindi, galit po sila sa rebuke po, mga kapatid, instead of listening to God's mercy through the rebuke of the prophets, they hate rebukes. Well, in fact, yung mga prophets na mas nauna kay Amos ay pinapatay nila, si Prophet Isaiah, Prophet Jeremiah, and the rest of the prophets, they suffered from the hands of the kings because kings and the leaders of God's people, they hate rebukes. Ayun. So, dahilan po sa they reject or they neglect the warning of the prophet. Ito po yung mangyayari po, mga kapatid, na pinilit na po ng prophet. Magkaroon ng kagutuman, magkaroon ng salot, and lastly, if they will not listen to those disasters na ipinahintulutan ng Panginoon na mangyayari sa kanila, is they will be captive in the other nation po, mga minamahal, mga kapatid. So the question is, how does Amos describe this judgment po, mga kapatid? Paano po dinescribe ni Amos itong judgment na ito? Let us read all together from verse 18 to 19 sa chapter 5 po, mga kapatid. Ang sabi diyan, "Alas for you who desire the day of the Lord. Why do you want the day of the Lord? It is darkness and not light." Yung day of the Lord po, mga kapatid, is another expression of the judgment. Pag sinabi pong day of the Lord sa Old Testament, it connotes judgment or the second coming of Jesus Christ. So sabi niya sa verse 18, "Alas for you desire the day of the Lord. Why do you want the day of the Lord? It is darkness and not light." Verse 19, "As if someone fled from a lion and was met by a bear, or went into the house and rested a hand against the wall and was beaten by a snake." Sa verse 19 po, mga kapatid. So this day of the Lord is described by Amos as the darkness, and not light. This day of the Lord or the judgment of God is expressed or described by Amos po, mga kapatid, na it is inescapable. O kumbaga, walang makakatakas po, mga kapatid. Ginamit yang larawan or example itong tao, as if someone fled from a lion and was met by a bear. Lumayo ka nga doon sa lion, nakaharap mo naman, nakasalubong mo naman yung oso, o kaya nakauwi kang payapa sa bahay mo, pag sandal mo ngayon, kinagat ka ng ahas. So ano pong ibig sabihin nito mga kapatid? The day of the Lord, the judgment of God, ay wala pong makakatakas. Liban na lang po doon sa mga zealous people of God. Okay, sa verse na sa chapter 9 verse 1 and 2, sa salin po ng NRSB. Ang sabi po diyan, "The Lord said, strike the capitals until the threshold shake and shatter them on the heads of all the people, and those who are left I will kill with the sword. Not one of them shall flee away, not one of them shall escape." Verse 2, "Though they dig into Sheol, from there shall my hand take them. Though they climb up to heaven, from there I will bring them down." Mga kapatid, this judgment of the Lord, wala pong makakatakas. This judgment of the Lord, mga kapatid, ay wala po tayong lugar na mapupuntahan, because God will bring His judgment and His execution to those people who deny and who neglect His appeal of mercy for them not to be part of this execution or judgment of God. Verse 3 and 4. "Though they hide themselves on the top of Carmel, from there I will search out and take them. And though they will hide from my sight at the bottom of the sea, there I will command the sea serpent, and it shall bite them." And verse 4, "And though they will go into captivity in front of their enemies, there I will command the sword, and it shall kill them." Mga kapatid, tandaan po natin, in this book, the two main theme is what? First is judgment. Second is repentance. When God pronounced judgment, He always appeal for repentance. Kapag ang Diyos ay nag-pronounce ng judgment, He is always appealing for repentance po para yung mga tao ay hindi mapahamak po mga kapatid. Verse 21 and 22 sa chapter 5. "The Lord says, I hate and reject your peace. I cannot stand your religious meetings." Verse 22. "If you offer me burnt offerings and grain offerings, I won't accept them. You bring your best fellowship offerings of fattened cattle, but I will ignore them." Tandaan po natin, sinabi po ng Biblia sa aklat po ng Samuel, that obedience is better than sacrifice. No matter how we sacrifice in our worship to God, no matter how generous we are in giving our offerings, no matter how generous we are in how faithful we are in returning our tithes and offerings to God, but if there is no real changes in our life, if there is no real revival and reformation in our lives, if there is no real transformation in our lives, mga minamahal na mga kapatid, God will reject and will not accept our worship. It is a very solemn appeal for us, mga minamahal na mga kapatid. God is not really concerned of how we worship Him in looks, but God wants a real transformation in our hearts. Sabi po doon sa isang quotation ng aking nabasa po mga kapatid, "Genuine repentance is not when you cry, but it's when you change." Hindi po yung umiyak tayo sa harapan ng Panginoon, no? Genuine repentance is not when we cry, but it is when we change ourselves by the grace of God and surrender our whole being to God. Verse 23 and 24. "Take the noise of your songs away from me. I won't listen to the music of your harps. But let justice flow like a river, and let goodness flow like a never-ending stream." Instead of focusing on physical worship po mga kapatid, God is appealing mga kapatid to do justice, to love mercy, and let this justice flow like a river. Pag sinabi po mga kapatid, justice flow like a river, nais po ng ating Panginoon na it will be in natural para sa atin na gumawa ng mabuti. Hindi yung gumagawa tayo ng mabuti, meron lamang time, pero hindi po consistent. That's not a picture of justice and goodness flow like a river. So, dapat maging natural sa atin po mga kapatid as we have this relationship to God. Kaya sabi ito, let justice flow like a river and let the goodness of God flow like a never-ending stream. So verse 4 and 5, this is the final appeal of Amos to the people of Israel. And sabi niya, the Lord speaks to the people of Israel. He says, look to me and live. Do not look to Bethel. Do not go to Gilgal. Do not travel to Beersheba. The people of Gilgal will be taken away as prisoners. Nothing will be left of Bethel. Mga kapatid, this place, Bethel, Gilgal, and Beersheba is one of they are the most important place sa mga Israel, mga kapatid. Bethel is a place where God revealed to Jacob through his dreams. Gilgal is a place where the people of Israel consecrate themselves and meet for fellowship to worship God. And Beersheba is a place where God reveals to Hagar and including Abraham. In other words, mga kapatid, Bethel, Gilgal, and Beersheba is a place of worship. But let us try to look and reflect from this verse po, mga kapatid. Ang sabi po ng ating Panginoon, look to me and live. Do not look to me and to Bethel. Do not go to Gilgal. Do not travel to Beersheba. In other words, mga kapatid, if we're going to apply this in our time, do not go to church for you to have a genuine revival. Sa panahon natin ngayon, we are restrained to have a physical gathering sa atin po mga churches. Sa mga buildings po mga kapatid, we are restrained to do so. And this message is really very timely. Do not look to me, to the church, to the building, but rather look to me and live. Mga kapatid, I would like to appeal on this. Genuine revival, it's not happen corporately. It's not happen on the church, but rather genuine revival happens to us personally. If we choose to look to God, to focus our eyes to God and live according to His will. Kaya sabi po dyan sa verse 4, look to me and live. Verse 6, Israel, look to the Lord and live. If you don't, He will sweep through the tribes of Joseph like a fire. And it will burn everything up and Bethel won't have anyone to put it out. Verse 14 and 15, last mga kapatid. Seek good and not evil, that you may live. Then the Lord God Almighty will be with you, just as you say He is. Verse 15, hate evil, love good, maintain justice in the courts. Perhaps the Lord God Almighty will have mercy on the remnant of Joseph. What does it mean to seek the Lord? To seek the Lord is to seek good. To seek the Lord is to seek good and not evil. To seek the Lord is to hate evil and to love good. If we are saying that we are seeking the Lord, then seek good. If we are saying that we are seeking the Lord, then hate evil and love righteousness po mga minamahal na mga kapatid. This impending doom ay nangyari po mga kapatid sa not just to Israel but to the kingdom of Judah as well. Upon hearing this horrible judgment na mangyayari po sa chosen people of God, mga kapatid, Amos prayed for intervention. Amos prayed for intervention. Chapter 7, verse 3 and 6. Ang sabi nito ni Amos, let us start reading from verse 2. And so it was, when they had finished eating the grass of the land, that I said, O Lord God, forgive, I pray, O that Jacob may stand, for he is small. Verse 6. So the Lord relented concerning this. This also shall not be, said the Lord God. Mga kapatid, Amos is praying not for himself, but rather Amos is praying for the sake of the people of God, for God, for him to relent his judgment na kanyang pinopronounce na mangyari sa bayan po ng atin pong Panginoon. This prayer of Amos also reminds us the prayer of Moses when God was about to destroy the murmuring people of Israel, but Moses intervenes in behalf of them for to relent God from His judgment. This prayer of intervention of Amos po mga kapatid is remind us the prayer of Daniel intervening the people who is in captive in order for him to present the case of his people to God, and God will fulfill His promise to them. Mga kapatid, it's not bad to pray for ourselves. It's not bad to pray for our families. But how we pray to other people as well, like not member of our family. How we pray for our neighbors. How we pray for our government official. How we pray for those people around us po mga kapatid. How we pray for those who are victim of what so-called this pandemic po mga kapatid. How we prayed for other people, for them to open their minds, for them to acknowledge God in their lives. Mga kapatid, this prayer of Amos is a prayer for intervention for God to relent his judgment concerning to what he has already been pronounced na mangyayari sa Judah and Israel. But unfortunately mga kapatid, despite of the warnings of God, despite of the appeal for mercy and repentance to the people of Israel, the northern kingdom, they do not genuinely repent from their sin, but remain in their condition po mga kapatid, and finally they were captive, and they were captive by the kingdom of Assyrians noong 722 BC, and they were scattered to the surrounding nation, and until our time today there is no original 10 tribes po mga kapatid. They are mixed with other blood of other nation po mga minamahal na mga kapatid. But the book of Amos not ended on the judgment, but rather the book of Amos ended on the promise of restoration, that God will restore His people, not just the physical Judah and Israel, the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, but including the Gentiles as well, including us who will choose to obey Him, who will choose to repent from our sin, and who will choose to Jesus as our Lord and King. This promise is not just promise to the Israel, but also a promise to each one of us that God will restore us, and God is preparing a new home for us, and that is no other than in heaven. Mga kapatid, as in a film, have you been in a point, mga kapatid, that while we are in this pandemic, naisip nyo na ba na ito po ay judgment ng ating Panginoon? Sa akin personally, dumating po ako sa punto na iniisip po, Lord, is it one of the seven last plagues? And because of that po, mga kapatid, I try to study I study once again the prophecies in the Bible concerning this judgment. We study together the book of Revelation, and by God's enlightenment, we make a program in our district focusing on studying Revelation. And by God's grace po mga kapatid, ay na-cover po natin yung aklat po ng Revelation from chapter 1 until chapter 22 po ng aklat of Revelation. Maybe this is kasi pag sinabing pandemic or salot, when we are going to look back at the history as well as in the Old Testament in Egypt, masasabi po natin that it is one of God's judgment kasi salot ito, but it's not one of the seven last plagues. Kasi concerning that, when we are going to study the book of Revelation, the seven last judgment of God or the seven last plagues will be poured out when there will be a universal implementation or a universal enforcement of the Sunday law. So dahil sa wala pa namang universal implementation ng Sunday law, so this pandemic, we can rest assured po mga kapatid that this pandemic that happening around us nowadays is not part of the seven last plagues, but rather it is one of the signs that telling us that we are now in the end time, and the Lord Jesus Christ will come very soon. Probably this moment that we are in this pandemic. Napakarami po nating time. Indeed, napakarami po nating time para gawin ang mga bagay na gusto natin. But let us always remember po mga kapatid, this pandemic is God's extension of mercy for us to seek Him, for us to seek the Lord and live, to search His Word, to evaluate ourselves, to see kung ano na po ba yung ating relationship sa ating Panginoon. And if there is something wrong with our relationship to God right now, God's appeal for us is to seek Him and live, to repent from our sins, and to surrender our whole lives to Him. God bless at may the Lord God be with us all throughout this Sabbath day.
Amen, Pastor. Amen.
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 Amen.